This is your weekly moment of growth. Hurt people tend to hurt other people. But here is the problem with this scenario. There's a lot of people, including myself years ago, where we felt like we had to help the people that were hurt all the time, even if that meant for us to continuously be hurt in the scenario. And the reality is, it's not our job to help those people. If they're hurting us, it's time to leave. And I don't care if these people are a significant other, a family member, a coworker, a boss, it is time to step away from the situation. If you're being hurt, you must remove yourself. One of the things I touch on all the time is about how we need to fill our cups first before we're even able to help anybody else. Well, if this hurt person is hurting us, we're not filling our own cup. Sometimes when we remove ourselves from the situation, we're able to help that person in the long run. So there was a time in my life where I had to remove myself from my father's life. There were 7.5 years where my father and I did not say one word to each other. It comes to a point when we can no longer care about the pain that somebody else has gone through if they're putting us through pain. So how are you able to remove yourself from this situation? Step one is to make sure you're taking care of yourself. Check yourselves. Make sure you're not feeding into this hate. Make sure you're not feeding into the hurt that they're giving you. A lot of times, we bring our own damage into that situation. So how can we step away and start to fill our own cups and address the things that we're bringing to this scenario that are making it worse? And whatever those things are, begin to correct them. And this could take time. So the second step is give it time. Don't think that a couple hours, a couple weeks, a couple months away from this person who's hurt is going to correct it. A lot of times, even when we go through the steps and we do the work we need to do to get better, they're not doing the work at the same time. So allowing ourselves to be removed from the situation, when reintroduced to this hurt situation, it starts the cycle all over again. And it's really, really impossible to pick up where you left off. So you want to make sure you give it time for yourself and allow yourself to heal from this hurt situation. Step three, forgive yourself for feeling like the victim and take back the power. A lot of times when we're in these scenarios, whether again, it's within a relationship or with our boss or with a coworker or a business partner, we've kind of submitted, right? And so since we've submitted to the scenario, it's hard for us to forgive ourselves. And so we continue to go down this path because we're like, well, we've gone this far. Why not see it through? You have to forgive yourself for allowing you to submit, and you have to take back the power of the situation. This is a huge step. It's really, really hard, and it's almost impossible for a lot of people. But the way to do this is to focus on your strengths as an individual and focus on what you bring to the world versus that individual. Does that make sense? So take back your power. And number four, go be a badass. You don't need other people's opinions and encouragement to be your own badass. So I want you guys to go grab the bull by the horns this week and go be a badass. Remove yourself from these toxic situations in your life and take back the power.